Hi everybody. Hello, boys and girls. I am Flipper 55 of Fat Finger Gaming, and welcome to Fat Finger Gaming's continuing coverage of the 2015 college football season. You might think the games get more important. Today is an SEC West matchup. It's Texas A&M, number 20 Texas A&M, 0-1 in the conference versus Mississippi State, 0-2. You can see they share at the bottom. A loss here for Mississippi State. Mathematically, it doesn't mathematically bury them, but it does bury them if they're not dead already. All right, so there is Dak Prescott. Now, many of you have been watching the Mississippi State games, or for that matter, watching the recaps. I have mentioned Dak Prescott coming back for his senior year and just not doing well. Apparently, I need to look into what I am talking about. Dak Prescott, I swore last January when people were talking about announcing and all that fun stuff, I swore that Dak Prescott was being talked about as a late first, early second, mid second at the latest draft pick. I guess I'm full of it. I guess it must have been one of those things that maybe I heard when Mississippi State was doing well during the season and just, like, stuck with me. I mean, we all get that. We have this thought, and all of a sudden it becomes true in our head, and we won't get off of it. Because I can't find anything justifying the fact that he was going to be that picked that high in the draft. And certainly in articles that I've seen, they're not really expecting him to do anything. I think actually somebody has him rated as a undrafted free agent. So, all right, my bad. I guess Dak Prescott wasn't as big a prospect as I thought he was. And so far he has not looked good in Fat Fingers world. So far Mississippi State is 0-2. Their offense has looked downright horrendous against LSU and Auburn. Now granted, LSU and Auburn, especially Auburn, have got very, very good defenses. So we'll see. You know, Mississippi State is probably playing the worst defensive team that they will play in the SEC West here against Texas A&M, so we'll have to see. And right off the bat, Dak Prescott leads his team down for a touchdown. So we'll see. We will see if it has everything to do with who they have, who they've gone up against, or if they really are just that bad. A loss here for Mississippi State. Mississippi State already is in trouble. A loss here would bury him as far as any hopes of actually winning the division. For Texas A&M, Texas A&M is coming off of a loss to Arkansas in Jerry's World. They played very, very, very well. They do have some injuries, though, at wide receiver. However, the one guy that they still have, Ricky Seals-Jones. So far, he's second in receiving in the league, in the conference. Sorry, he's definitely leading the conference, second in the nation, only below some SMU wide receiver that I keep wishing that I looked up every time Texas A&M plays. Ricky Seals-Jones, however, only caught, I think he only caught three balls for around 60 yards in the loss against Arkansas. I mean, 60 yards is not not a horrible thing, but that considering the dude has basically been over 100 yards in every game he's been in, yes, that is definitely a downturn. But hopefully Texas A&M can find them, and here at Kyle Field, they can actually walk away with their first SEC win, go to 1-1, an 0-2 start. 0-2 starts are bad, are really, really bad. Especially in the SEC West. If it was the SEC East, in which one of those losses was an interdivisional thing, you still have a shot. But both Texas A&M, just like Mississippi State, the games would be both against a divisional opponent. Mississippi State still needs to go through a lot of their
quick out to his receiver.
Their SEC schedule. Sorry, sitting here watching, waiting for Ricky Seals Jones, who is actually at the top of the screen. Come on, go deep. Let's get a Ricky Seals Jones sighting here. No, don't hand off the ball. Anyways. So we'll see how long it takes before Ricky Seals-Jones actually makes a catch and see if he can eat up this Mississippi State defense. And once again, who knows? Maybe he can't. Oh, jeez. Kyle Allen goes down there. Maybe he can't play against SEC opponents. Maybe it was just the fact that he was playing against weaker defenses that he was able to run up that big of a...
Moves up in the pocket. That's a great tackle at the 34-yard line.
I'm waiting. I saw Jones release at the top. I thought maybe that's who might have been Kyle Allen. That's probably why I was looking at him and getting sacked. So Texas A&M got settled for a field goal, and that is just barely good.
Great snap and a perfect hold, and he just had an awesome
7-3. I was about to talk about the fact that so far last week the SEC games were good. They were close. Kentucky, Missouri wasn't good, but it was close, and it did have its makings of a fun game, especially at the end. But you know, this week's completely different. So far, we've had the only reason why you'd stick around to watch the ends of the game is just because, you know, those teams were showing life. They really were showing life, trying to get back in it, but it just was a little too late. Too late for those guys. Anyways, this is supposed to be a bottom of the division game. Many people, when given odds to win this division, have Texas A&M 6th, Mississippi State 7th, which is... it's just weird. I would really like to know why I thought Dak Prescott was going to be so good. Was going to be picked so high, just because this is the thing that boggles my mind. Normally, when a quarterback, I don't care what you have as a surrounding team, normally when a good quarterback makes his return in a senior year, you don't put him last in the division. I can't think of anybody who's ever happened, but. As I've said before, so far I can't. I've looked through articles trying to find where I was basing the Dak Prescott, maybe a first round draft pick last year from. Obviously, I was wrong, and just it does boggle my mind when I'm wrong. No, it doesn't really. Oh, you gotta be kidding me! And then it almost was picked. No, he caught it. Oh my God! The linebacker came up to welcome Kyle Allen. Blocker picked him up just in the nick of time, and then he threw across his body, across the field. I'm still waiting for Ricky Seals Jones. It's gonna suck if he flames out. He was a good story. He was a real good story. Now I gotta pick somebody else if he's gonna flame out. He's still right there. He's close right off the tackle. Not that good of a release. He's still covered. All right, so this is the bottom of the division. Probably going to be the bottom of the division game. Texas A&M has come out looking very good. I mean, they do look good, despite the fact that they're picked for the bottom of the barrel. First, when you see those things,
well, he's being forced to make really quick decisions.
I think they'll finish ahead of LSU. It will be very, very interesting if LSU finishes low in the division. They obviously already have a win against Mississippi State. They probably won't finish naked last, but
throws it to the halfback on the screen.
He's taken down.
I wonder when the last time LSU did finish butt naked last in the division, if they ever have.
Well, the offense hurt themselves by digging themselves into a hole on first and second down. So the
I can only imagine like well, Auburn did finish buck naked last. I was gonna say, and that cost cost a job of a dude who just a couple years before that won the national championship. So that. I was going to say, I can only imagine what would happen if Alabama, LSU, or Auburn finished last in the division. But then again, I don't have to imagine. It doesn't matter if you're a national championship winner or not. Only, you know, a couple years removed, you're gone. So, very interesting. Can't think of too much storylines here for this game. Just hopefully Dak Prescott can actually provide some offense this game. Get Mississippi State the first SEC win. And not fall to 0-3 in the conference. Texas A&M trying to rebound from that Arkansas game. And, you know, hopefully they still got a shot at this. They played well against Arkansas. They could have beaten Arkansas. So if they could have beaten Arkansas, I really do think they can beat LSU. They should be able to beat Auburn. They should be able to beat these guys, which obviously is not going too well right now. Especially at home, guys. Where's the 12th man? All right, guys. I hope you enjoy the game. Hope you enjoy the season. I am out of here. Y'all have fun. 37-yard line.
They go to the ground game, and he's taken down at the 29-yard line.
That's a gain of 8 on the play.
From the 29-yard line. First down.
Roger, Roger. Keep 15.
He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Gets to about the 24-yard line.
To watch quarterbacks on third down, to just kind of see where they are as far as their psyche and their approach to the game. This is another big third down. He was able to sit back, evaluate the defense, had just enough time to be able to make the throw to pick up the first down.
Nice move, and he scores. What a spectacular run by the quarterback.
That is such a weapon for your offense. When you have a quarterback who can do things like that, the coach probably loves drawing up plays for this guy.
And he tacks on the extra point.
A 9-play, 76-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running backs.
So the score now is 14-6. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Everywhere we go in college football, everybody's got a T-shirt that says finish, finish. Whether that means finish the game or finish the drive. Right now, this offense is moving the ball, but they're not finishing the drive. They got to execute better down closer to their opponent's territory.
And he is drilled at the 18.
That's a loss of 7 yards. That'll make it second and long.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation.
Oh, yeah, I'm coming. Oh, yeah, I'm coming.
Hey, check Mike 39. Check Mike.
Let's go.
Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete.
The ball just sailed on him, and he knows it. He'll get it next time.
That'll bring up third and long.
Larry.
They come out on an empty backfield.
Ready.
Gets it out quickly. And he's tackled at about the 35.
Brown with the tackle at the 35-yard line.
Get out.
That makes it fourth and inches.
He punts it away, and it's a great kick. Tackle made at the 28-yard line. Mississippi State's lighting up the scoreboard so far, and the guys on the other sideline are having to settle for field goals.
And that's got to change if they're going to have a chance to be able to win this game. They're moving the ball well, but they've got to put the ball into the end zone.
A long ways yet to go, but at the end of one, the Bulldogs in front by eight. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He tackles him for a loss.
The D-line did a good job of nullifying out the blocks up front, and that allowed the linebacker to roam free and make the tackle in the backfield.
From their own 26-yard line, second down, Mississippi State up by eight. Gains his way to the 39-yard line.
He gets another set of downs and, more importantly, opens up a whole host of play-calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
Roger, Roger. Devin's the mark. Hey, pick it up, defense. Let's go.
And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
Honeycutt makes the tackle at the 48-yard line. That'll make it second and inches.
Brought down at the 46.
Honeycutt on the tackle at the 46-yard line. First down.
Key 15, key 15. All day, all day. Ready, ready. Easy, easy, ready. Easy. Ready. Rally, ready. Rally.
Tackled after decent pickup.
On the carry. Gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
He's on the run. He's at the 30. He gets out to about the 21-yard line.
That's a gain of 21 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Watch 32. Watch 32. Here we go, D. Here I come again. Here I come again. Ready. Check 32.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
This is the eighth play of this drive. In the shotgun and five wideouts. Throws it out and it falls incomplete.
Ross, the intended receiver on the play. That brings up third and 10.
From the 21-yard line. Third down. Mississippi State is up by eight. Under pressure, and he can't get away from the pressure.
That's a loss of 8 yards. That makes it fourth and long.
Mississippi State is hoping to make this a two-score game. He gets it up, and it's long enough, and it's wide left. No good. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. He's tackled right around the 42-yard line. Five wide. Looking for his man, incomplete.
Holmes, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 42-yard line. Second down.
Roger, Roger. Hey, check Mike 39. Check Mike 39.
Ready.
Stepping up. Tries to fit it in there, and it'll be intercepted.
Redmond with the interception.
Impressed with this guy's closing speed on the ball. He's got the kind of jets you need to be a standout corner.
First and 10, ball on their own 42. He makes his way to about the 48.
That's a gain of 10 on the play. That'll make it second and inches.
Here we go. Tie right.
Mississippi State holds an 8-point advantage. Hands it to the back. And they push him out at the 46-yard line.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. First down.
Tight end left. Four down. Mike seven. Yeah.
Give to the running back, and he's going to lose yardage. Second down now, 14 to go. Ball on the 50-yard line. Tackle around the 40-yard line.
Call it a gain of 10 yards. That'll bring up third and four.
Man left. Three down. Seven's a mic.
They run it for the first, and he stops.
Call it a loss of 2 yards on the play. That'll make it fourth and six.
And they could really put their opponent in bad field position with a good punt here. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. For Mississippi State, they've been bringing the heat, and they've gotten to them on several occasions. Good pass rush by these guys today.
They also have that one takeaway.
This offense hasn't had any trouble moving the ball on the ground.
Well, they are running it pretty well, so that wouldn't be a bad thing. You take the yards however you can get them.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man, and he's level at the 40. He's going to try and scramble. And they bring him down for a sack on the play.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
I'm coming. Hey, check Mike 39.
Ready. Green in the 8. Tiger.
He's on the run. That's a great tackle at the 43.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That makes it 3rd and 7.
Larry. Hey, check Mike 39.
Check four.
And he's sacked. Can this offense do anything to slow down this defense?
Well, they need to start keeping their backs in to help out in blocking. The quarterback is getting pounded back there.
This is a great punt-blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. It's away, and it's a booming punt. He's taken down at the 24-yard line. Mississippi State's offense is just clicking on all cylinders, Herbie, right now. It's everything they planned for, and it's all working.
Everything is coming together for this offense. They seem to be getting better with each series. And, you know, this game started where this team was, you know, they wondered if they were going to be able to move the ball against this defense. And I think right now, I think they seem to, as I said earlier, they seem to be growing with their confidence with each possession.
And he hits him hard at the 37.
That's good for a gain of 13 yards. That makes it 1st and 10.
Roger. Mike 7.
Mississippi State up by 8. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
With a run. That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
Come on, baby. Come on. Let's go. 7's a Mike. Mike 7.
They bring him down in the backfield.
Did you see how quickly he was able to get into the backfield and make that tackle? Not many guys that big can move that fast.
From their own 38-yard line, it's 3rd down. He's at midfield, and he's got his receiver. It's the sophomore. And down he goes at the 42-yard line.
At the 42-yard line. First down.
Not over here.
Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
Mike 7.
Here we go. 36.
He's taken down at the 25.
Call it a gain of 15 yards. First down.
Fires quick. Tipped.
Excellent pass defense. You've got to be able to make a lightning quick reaction to bat the ball away like he did right there.
From the 25-yard line, it's second down. And they get the sack.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush because sacks can be real drive killers.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Mississippi State is up by 8. Fakes to the back. He's at the 20. Tackle made at the 20-yard line. They'll line it up for the field goal. Mississippi State can make this a 2-possession game with this field goal. It's up, and it's good. Bell has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. We're about set to start things up again. Was almost picked.
Number 9 was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second
from their own 25-yard line.
Hey,
second down. He's scrambling. He airs it out. He goes up, picked off.
Number 13 makes the interception.
That's the last thing they needed to happen was an interception. They're trying to fight to get back into this game, and to have that miscue, now it's really up to their defense to try to help them out.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 29. And they get nice yardage on that run. Good gain by the tailback of about 7 on the option play. The Bulldogs will use their first time out of the half. And he's going to come up with a sack. Texas A&M will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. And for Garrett, that was sack number 2.
You know, for the rest of the game now, he's going to be looking for this guy every time he drops back to pass. Let's see if that throws off his timing.
And they make the stop right around the 40. Mississippi State's going to have to use their second time out of the half.
That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on their own 40. One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. They bring him down. So at the end of the half, the Bulldogs lead 17-6. All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Bulldogs continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
They'll bring him down at the 41-yard line.
Well, the quarterback's able to find a soft spot in the defense, and he threw an accurate ball for a solid pickup.
And he carries the ball for a nice gain. To about the 41-yard line.
Gain of 14 yards. First down.
And he's taken down around the 28-yard line. Come out in a five-wide set.
Here we go. Kill,
kill, kill, kill, kill. He's out of bounds at about the 25-yard line. Quick throw out to the receiver. What a play, and that is first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
First and goal from the one, looking to punch this one in. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Now he's scrambling. They bring the quarterback down.
And a loss of 5 yards on the play. That brings up second and goal.
And this is the eighth play of the drive.
Larry, Larry, Larry! Hey, check Mike 39. Check Mike 39.
Ready!
Here they come. Just throws this one away. The defense has really held their own the last two plays. Now it's third and goal from the seven. And it's almost picked off.
Double on the coverage. That brings up fourth and goal.
And they can make this a one possession game with this kick right here. He gets it up. And he got it. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
Yellow Jackets take the field today as the number 21 team in the country. The Yellow Jackets' rushing attack can be difficult to stop, and they get into the end zone for a touchdown.
They line up to kick this one away. Excellent kick. He makes it out to maybe the 16-yard line. It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? Mississippi State holds an 8-point advantage. Throws complete, and he's got space to work. And he's finally knocked out of bounds at the 47-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 31 yards.
Right and left, right and left.
That makes it first and 10.
Three down, three down. Seven's a Mike. Mike seven. Check three, check three, check three.
There's a strike complete, he's down.
Gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
Seven's a Mike. Check three, check three, check three.
Makes it out to about the 33.
Call it a gain of 13 yards. First down.
85, I'm coming for you. I'm coming for you. Here we go. Here we go.
Ready. Easy, easy, easy.
Pass is caught. The defense lays him out.
Gain of 4 on the play. That makes it second and 6.
Let's go, defense. And here we go.
Mike 7. Mike 7.
Brought down at the 20.
Gain of 9 on the play.
Mike
7.
Mike 7. Larry, Larry, Larry. Watch 85. Ball going 85. Watch 85.
Tackled after a decent run up the gut.
Gain of six on the play. That brings up second and five.
Second down and five. Ball on the 14.
Seven's a Mike. Mike seven.
Here we go. Check, check. Regular.
They'll get him for a loss.
You know, it looked to me like he should have made the pitch, but he kept it instead and wound up going backwards.
This is the eighth play of this drive. And he is drilled at the 26-yard line.
Great play by the defense.
Ooh, that time they came with the blitz, and the linebacker was able to get free and come away with a sack.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. Mississippi State is hoping to make this a two-score game. And he just drilled it from long range.
Boy, he had plenty of distance there and pushed it through. Very impressive leg strength.
20-9, Mississippi State. Looks like they're ready for the kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Mississippi State coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this. And another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Quick out to his receiver. Tackle around the 26-yard line.
Harris makes the tackle.
So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. And he shoved out of bounds around the 29-yard line. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver look. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. Complete. He's tackled at the 48-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That'll make it second and four.
Roger.
Defensive coordinator anticipating this five-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. And he's tackled at the 49.
That is a loss of 1 yard. That'll make it third and five.
Check Mike 39. Check Mike 39.
Quick throw. Almost intercepted.
Reynolds, the intended receiver on the play. Fourth down.
Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position.
Sometimes it's not the huge distance, but precision that you need from your punter. Nicely done.
The offense ready to go again. And their last drive ended with 3 points.
Mike seven. Here we go.
He fights forward to about the 16. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
That makes it second and 10.
Trying to get it to the tight end, but it falls to the ground.
Samuel, the intended receiver on the play. That brings up third and 10.
From their own 16-yard line. Third down. And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five receiver look. And he's hit immediately.
That's a gain of 15 on the play. First down.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. And down he goes around the 46-yard line.
Call it a gain of 15 yards. First down.
Larry. Mike seven.
The offense going to try to open this field up coming out in a five wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. Got it and brought down immediately.
Gain of 5 yards. That brings up second and five.
Reset, tight right. Mike seven.
Nice pitch and catch for the first down.
That's a great tackle at the 40-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Roger, Roger!
They'll spread the field with five wide.
Hey, pick your game up.
Let's go.
Easy, easy, easy. Buffalo.
He's pushed out of bounds at the 37-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
And he tackles him hard at the 23.
Gain of 14 on the play. First down.
It's the ninth play of the drive.
Three down.
Ready!
And he hits him hard at the 21-yard line. Inside the 10. And he's level at the 4-yard line.
Call it a gain of 17 yards. That makes it first and goal.
Roger, Roger. Three down. Mike 14. Check 99.
He's going to try and scramble. And he's sacked.
Makes the sack. Loss of 7 yards on the play. That brings up second and goal.
It's second and goal. Ball on the 11. Fires to his tight end, nothing doing.
Samuel was the intended receiver on the play.
13th play of the drive coming up.
Mike 7.
Yeah, that's what I do.
Ready!
Fires that quickly, incomplete.
Brown was the intended receiver on the play.
It's fourth down. This should be an easy field goal. The kick is up, and it's through the uprights. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
Have a look at what's going on in Durham. The Eagles continuing to pound the rock on the ground and score a touchdown.
Bell ready to kick. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt.
Down two possessions, this offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
With the pass, incomplete.
You know, he's been working really hard lately on his fundamentals. In fact, the other day in practice, I was really watching him work with the quarterback coach, and they've been focusing on that aspect of it. Here, it looked like he may have taken a step backwards and really just let that one go.
Zips it to the tailback, incomplete.
Carson, the intended receiver on the play. Third down.
We've got third and 10. Ball on the 25. Throws into a crowd, and this one's going the other way. Interception. Unbelievable. This defense just continues to impress.
This just must feel like a bad dream to this offensive coordinator. Nothing has gone right today, and his quarterback is really off target.
Makes it out to about the 26.
That's a gain of 12 on the play.
Tight end right.
First down.
Tight end right. Four down. Seven's a mic.
On the ground, and he won't get back to the line. From the 29-yard line. Second down.
Make it third and 13.
Roger, Roger! Mike 7!
Let's set a tone, fellas. Let's set a tone.
makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. So it's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. And this is still anyone's ball game as we head into the final quarter of play. The Bulldogs lead it by two touchdowns. It's up, and he splits the uprights. Mississippi State is lining up to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So the Aggies have just not been able to get that offense rolling at all today.
I think they're confused. I think it starts up front with the offensive line. They're not having the typical game that you'd expect to see from them as far as communication. I think it's affected the rest of the offense.
Now here comes the offense, and you've got to wonder if that last interception's weighing on the quarterback's mind at all.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun.
Let's go.
Looks to him again, complete. He's taken down at the 46. They come out in an empty backfield.
Here we go.
And they make the stop at the 35-yard line.
Here we go.
Got his receiver, dropped it, incomplete. It's second and 10. Ball on the 35-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
That is a loss of five on the play. That brings up third and 14.
Watch the slant. Watch the slant.
Hey, check Mike 39. Check Mike 39.
Set.
Cut. He launches one for the end zone.
Incomplete pass. Gonzalez, the intended receiver on the play.
It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it.
Check. 200.
Throws it deep. Can't connect.
When the first down marker is that far away, someone's got to step up and make a play on fourth down. It just didn't happen for him here.
Nine times out of ten, the defense will make a stop on that play. But, you know, based on the situation, this offense did have to go for it.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop.
They keep it on the ground with a tailback, and they'll bring him down behind the line.
That is a loss of 1 yard.
Right and left, right and left.
That'll bring up second and 11.
Down, two down.
Seven, one. Here we go. Eagle.
Tackle made at the 49-yard line.
Gain of 10 yards. That'll bring up third and inches.
Tight right, tight right. Three down, three down. Three down. Mike seven.
He's got an opening. And he's taken down around the 41-yard line.
That's a gain of 10 on the play.
High five, baby. High five.
That makes it first and 10.
Man left, man left.
Three down, three down.
Three down, three down. Mike seven.
Yeah. Navajo. Navajo.
He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
From the 39-yard line, second down.
Seven's a Mike. Mike seven.
Yeah, let's go sack lunch.
Ready. Red 18. Red 18.
He gets out to about the 38-yard line.
That's a gain of 1 on the play. That makes it third and 7.
just throws this one away. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Strike to the receiver. They'll bring him down around the 28-yard line.
With the tackle at the 28-yard line. First down.
Watch the run. Watch the run.
Mike 7. Mike 7.
Throws it in a hurry. Brought down around the 21-yard line.
Number 7 makes the tackle at the 21-yard line. That'll bring up second and 3.
Mike 7. Mike 7. God, no.
He gets rid of this one. And this is the 10th play of the drive.
Seven's a Mike. Mike 7.
Reset. Tight right.
Key 15. Key 15. Let's go.
He gets out to about the 18-yard line.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. First down.
Hey, let's get that ball, D. Let's get that ball.
Seven's a Mike.
Quick pass, and he's right there to knock it away.
Great reaction to get his hands in the way of that pass. That's not an easy play to make.
From the 18-yard line, second down.
Three down, three down. Mike 7. Mike 7.
Let's go.
He's on the run. Got the corner. The 5. Touchdown, Bulldogs. He hits the PAT. It was a 12-play, 59-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 25. And for Allen, it has not been an easy ride in this one.
But we knew coming in that this quarterback was going to face a great defense. And like any quarterback that believes in himself and has confidence, he thinks he can make every play, but because he hasn't had that success, I think he's starting to get happy. I think he's starting to force the issue a little bit instead of just letting the game come to him.
Tackle at about the 37-yard line.
Calhoun makes the tackle at the 37-yard line.
That's good enough for another Texas A&M first down.
There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
That makes it first and 10.
Roger. Hey, check Mike 39. Check Mike 39.
5 wide. He rifles it. That's what can happen when you run the same play.
Yeah, you need to be aware of that and try to mix things up to keep the defense off balance.
That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 48. Steps out of bounds at the 45.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That'll bring up 3rd and 6.
Offense lines up in a 5-wide set in the defense, anticipating pass here. Balls it in as he's pushed out of bounds.
Nice job of picking up the Mike linebacker blitz and hitting his man for the first down.
Steps out around the 27-yard line.
Gain of 3 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
Roger, Roger. Hey, check Mike.
They'll line up with 5 wide receivers.
Here we go, here we go.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 20.
Run, run, run.
Car
option. It's a handoff to the right. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line.
They're going
to
come up short here on this third down. The defensive line did a great job of getting some penetration, and the overall defensive effort was big there to set up this fourth down.
Slings it left. And it's incomplete.
I think they had to go for it given the circumstances. They just couldn't pull it off.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six.
Mike seven.
Easy.
He's tackled around the 29-yard line. Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 29-yard line.
Stingray!
Strike to his receiver, no good. A little too much juice on that one.
And this quarterback sometimes gets a little bit too excited back there and tries to put too much on it. He's got to relax and just make a good throw.
From their own 29-yard line, third down. And he's tackled at the 37.
Number seven on the tackle at the 37-yard line. First down.
Tie right. Four down. Mike seven.
A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter.
Let's go. Wide in the eight.
Gets out to around the 45.
Gain of 8 on the play. That makes it second and 2.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
I got you.
Mike seven.
Runs left and can't get back to the line of scrimmage.
That's a loss of 4 yards on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 6.
Takes it right. He can't get back to the line. The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. Takes it at the 21. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line.
Returns for a gain of 12 yards.
Nothing left here except to see the clock hit zero. A comeback is just not happening. And down he goes at about the 41. Texas A&M just took their first timeout. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Across the middle, the defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
Gonzalez, the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 2.
Reset, tight right. Hey, check Mike 39. Check Mike 39.
I don't think you got it, son.
Here we go. Green 19.
Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. Mississippi State staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happier.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.